Dear viewers, today in this session we will understand the Lamarckism. Birds evolved from dinosaurs, but question arise, those giant turn in the elegant lightweight creatures with wings? The answer is evolution. Evolution is a well supported explanation of phenomena that have occurred in the natural world. A theory in science is a well-tested hypothesis, not just a guess. Now, theories of evolution. First theory, Lamarck's theory of inheritance of acquired characters. Next, Darwin's theories of natural selection. Third one, mutation or theory of Hugo de Vries. And fourth one is modern theory or neo-Darwinism or synthetic theory. Theory of Lamarck, proposed by French naturalist Jean-Baptiste de Lamarck in 1809, his famous book Philosophie Zoologique. Actually, this theory is based on the comparison between the contemporary species of his time to fossil records. It is based on the inheritance of acquired characters, the changes developed in the body of an organism from normal characters. In response to the changes in environment, use and disuse of organ take place after so many generations to fulfill their new needs. Hence, Lamarck stressed on adaptations as means of evolutionary modifications. Lamarck theory based on new needs, use and disuse of organs, inheritance of acquired characters and speciation. First of all, we discuss new needs. Environment is the basic need of any living organisms. The changes in the environmental factor like light, temperature, medium, food, air, etc. The origin of new needs in the living organisms, especially animals due to migration of animals. The living organisms fulfill these new needs due to changes in habits or behavior. Now, use and disuse of organs. In case of animals, the new habit involves due to maximum use of organs and the disuse or lesser use of certain other organs which are of no use in new conditions. This use and disuse of organs greatly affect the form, structure, and functioning of the organs. Continuous and extra use of organs make them well organized, while the continued disuse of organs lead to their degeneration and ultimate disappearance. According to theory of use and disuse of organs, the organism acquires certain new characters due to environmental effect during its own lifespan. These characters known as acquired or adaptive characters. Inheritance of acquired characters. Lamarck believed that acquired characters are inherited and transmitted to the next generation. Due to the change in environmental conditions, their survival is increased. Now, speciation. According to Lamarck, every generation new characters are acquired and transmitted to next generations. Hence, new characters assemble generation after generation. After so many generations, a new species is formed. Living organism or their environmental condition is basic need. production of new organ is developed from a new need. Continued use of an organ, it more developed, while disuse, it degenerate. Acquired characters or modifications evolved by individuals during their lifetime. Acquired or inheritable characters accumulate new species after so many generations. Now, evidences in favor of Lamarckism. According to phylogenetic research of elephant, horse and other animals, evolution increases from simple to complex form. Development of long-necked and long four-limbed giraffe from deer-like ancestor is an example of effect of extra use and elongation of organ. Due to deficiency of food on the dry desert of Africa, so the gradual elongation of neck and forelimb take place, hence eat the leaves on the tree branches. Evolution of limbless, long slender body of snakes from limbed ancestors is an example of stretching of body and continued disuse of limbs. Flightless bird like ostrich evolved from flying ancestors due to continued disuse of wings, development due to well protected areas with plenty of food. Outcome of aquatic birds like geese and ducks from their terrestrial ancestors is an example of reduction of wings due to their continued disuse and for wedding purposes, waves development between their toes. These modifications induced due to competition and deficiency of food on land. Due to increase in length of legs and decrease in functional digits for fast running over hard ground, the ancestors of modern horse used to live in the area with soft ground and short leg with more number of functional digits. This gradually took to live in area with dry ground. Now, criticism of Lamarckism. Continuity of germplasm. Theory proposed by August Weismann in 1892. According to them, environmental factors do affect only somatic cells, not the germ cells. They suggested that germplasm is with special particle which control the development of parental characters in young ones. Hence, link between the generation is only through the germ cells. The somatic cells are not transferred to the next generation, so the death of an organism's acquired character must be lost. Hence, no role in evolution. Mendel's law of inheritance, also exception of Lamarckism. For example, Pavlov and Russian physiologist trained mice on hearing a bell. They come for food. They observe that training is not inherited in every generation. Similar case studied Weismann. They mutilated the tails of mice for about 22 generations and allow them for breed, but never born tailless mice. Small size feet of Chinese woman, tight waist of European ladies, boring of pinna of external ear and nose in Indian woman, not transmitted for one generation to another. There are number of examples in which there is reduction in the size of organs. For example, presence of weak muscles in wrestler son. Hence, Lamarckism was rejected. It was first comprehensive theory of biological evolution and stressed on adaptation to the environment. Many years later, scientists developed new ideas which published neo-Lamarckism. So students, next class we will discuss neo-Lamarckism. Thank you very much.